Stan, is everybody here?
Mr. President, the Secretary of State is in Vietnam, the Secretary of Defense is in Laos, and the Vice President is in Mexico City.
We can establish contact with them at any time if it's necessary. The undersecretaries are all here, of course.
Right. Now, General Turgeson, what's going on here?
Mr. President, about 35 minutes ago, General Jack Ripper, the commanding general of Burpleson Air Force Base, issued an order to the 34 B-52s of his wing, which were airborne at the time, as part of a special exercise we were holding called Operation Dropkick. Now, it appears that the order called for the planes to attack their targets inside Russia. The planes are fully armed with nuclear weapons with an average load of 40 megatons each. Now, the central display of Russia will indicate the position of the planes. The triangles are their primary targets. The squares are their secondary targets. The aircraft will begin penetrating Russian radar cover within 25 minutes.
General Turgeson, I find this very difficult to understand. I was under the impression that I was the only one in authority to order the use of nuclear weapons.
That's right, sir. You are the only person authorized to do so. And although I hate to judge before all the facts are in, it's beginning to look like General Ripper exceeded his authority.
It certainly does. Far beyond the point I would have imagined possible.
Well, perhaps you're forgetting the provisions of Plan R, sir.
Plan R?
Plan R is an emergency war plan in which a lower echelon commander may order nuclear retaliation after a sneak attack if the normal chain of command has been disrupted. You approved it, sir, you must remember. Surely you must recall, sir, when Senator Buford made that big hassle about our deterrent lacking credibility. The idea was for Plan R to be a sort of retaliatory safeguard.
A safeguard?
I admit the human element seems to have failed us here. But the idea was to discourage the Ruskies from any hope that they could knock out Washington and yourself, sir, as part of a general sneak attack and escape retaliation because of lack of proper command and control.
Well, I assume then that the planes will return automatically once they reach their fail-safe points.
Well, no, sir, I'm afraid not. You see, the planes were holding at their fail-safe points when the go code was issued. Now, once they fly beyond fail-safe, they do not require a second order to proceed. They will continue until they reach their target.
Then why haven't you radioed the planes countermanding the go code?
Well, I'm afraid we're unable to communicate with any of the aircraft.
Why?
As you may recall, sir, one of the provisions of Plan R provides that once the go code is received, the normal SSB radios in the aircraft are switched into a special coded device, which I believe is designated as CRM-114. Now, in order to prevent the enemy from issuing fake or confusing orders, CRM-114 is designed not to receive at all, unless the message is preceded by the correct three-letter code group prefix.
Then do you mean to tell me, General Turgeson, that you will be unable to recall the aircraft?
That's what sir. However, we are plowing through every possible three-letter combination of the code.
But since there are 17,000 permutations, it's going to take us about 2.5 days to transmit them all.
How soon did you say the planes would penetrate Russian radar cover?
About 18 minutes now, sir.
Are you in contact with General Ripper?
No, sir, no. General Ripper sealed off the base and cut off all communication.
Where did you get all this information?
General Ripper called Strategic Air Command headquarters shortly after he issued the go code. I have a portion of the transcript of that conversation if you'd like me to read it.
Read it.
The duty officer asked General Ripper to confirm the fact that he had issued the go code, and he said,
Yes, gentlemen. They are on their way in, and no one can bring them back. For the sake of our country and our way of life, I suggest you get the rest of SAC in after them. Otherwise, we will be totally destroyed by red retaliation. My boys will give you the best kind of start, 1,400 megatons worth, and you sure as hell won't stop them now. So let's get going. There's no other choice. God willing, we will prevail in peace and freedom from fear and in true health through the purity and essence of our natural fluids. God bless you all. And he hung up. We're still trying to figure out the meaning of that last phrase, sir.
There's nothing to figure out, General Turgidson. This man is obviously a psychotic.
Well, I'd like to hold off judgment on a thing like that, sir, until all the facts are in.
General Turgidson, when you instituted the human reliability tests, you assured me there was no possibility of such a thing ever occurring.
Well, I don't think it's quite fair to condemn a whole program because of a single slip-up, sir.
I want to speak to General Ripper on the telephone personally.
I'm afraid that's impossible, sir.
General Turgidson, I am becoming less and less interested in your estimates of what is possible and impossible.
General Faceman.
Yes, sir.
Are there any Army units stationed anywhere near Burfinson?
I'll just check, sir.
Hello. I told you never to call me here. Don't you know where I am? Well, look, baby, I can't talk to you now, but my president needs me. Of course, Bucky would rather be there with you.
President, what do you think about civil
defense? Of course, it isn't only physical. I deeply respect you as a human being. Someday I'm going to make you Mrs. Buck Turgidson. Yeah, oh, listen, huh? You go back to sleep, huh? And Bucky will be back there just as soon as he can. All right. Listen, sure. Don't forget to say your prayers.
Apparently, the 23rd Airborne Division is stationed 7 miles away at Alvarado.
General Faceman, I want them to enter the base, locate General Ripper, and put him in immediate telephone contact with me.
Yes, sir.
Mr. President, if I may advise, under condition red, it is standard procedure that the base be sealed off and the base defended by base security troops. Any force trying to enter there would certainly encounter very heavy casualties.
General Turgidson, with all due respect for your defense team, my boys can brush them aside without too much trouble.